HVAC is heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. And it also encompasses commercial refrigeration and commercial refrigeration applications. You would learn how to service, install, and repair air conditioning and refrigeration systems.
Most people who come out here assume that all they're going to learn to do is work on systems like in residential housing. But we go beyond that. We teach the students how to be technicians, but we've also got classes in load calculation, duct design, energy use analysis, things like that.
When someone says HVAC, you're like, air conditioning? Well, it's that, it's heating. There's actually ventilation, which is primary on indoor air quality, which is a big thing now, not a lot of people are doing it. It's also refrigeration, so coolers, refrigerators, freezers, they teach us everything about that too, so it's pretty impressive.
We go beyond just a service tech. We train what we want to believe are going to be the next generation of contractors out there, the men who can sit down with a set of blueprints, start there, work through a load calculation, figure out exactly what you need for your house, design the system, put it in, and then have the capability to go in and test the system and make sure that it's been put in like you said it would be put in.
We're very fortunate that Pitt Community College has the resources to build these project houses, at least two on the campus.
You take them out there, we put them into the roof, we put them under the house, piping, ductwork, stuff like that.
It's a lot of hands-on on the program. That's probably the best part about it is one day, for like an hour or 2 hours part-time, you're in the classroom, they teach you the basics. Then, so you can grasp the knowledge, they bring you into the lab, that you can get your hands on the equipment, see what you're learning, and actually work on what you're learning on, which makes it a lot easier.
They have to want to work with their hands. They have to not be afraid to work out in inclement weather, whether it's very hot or it's very cold. That's when you're going to get most of your service calls, because that's when people need you the most.
If they find that that aspect of going under houses and that is not for them, there are a lot of factories around here that have commercial refrigeration, heat, and the hospitals around here, East Carolina University, Pitt Community College, these maintenance guys, somebody's got to take care of that.
When you get a project and it's like take an air conditioning unit that's not working and you look over and you actually see what's wrong with it and you notice what's wrong with it, and then once you're able to fix it, it's rewarding to see that you can do it, which a lot of times that's why people do it, because they like to see the completion of a project.
The breadth of the field is so incredibly wide. When I was a student here a long time ago, my instructor told me, he goes, this is the best job in the world because you'll never be unemployed unless you want to be, and nobody's going to take my job. They can't outsource this to China. I can take this job anywhere I go.
I originally had a friend that is in the industry in Raleigh, and I was looking for future work because I was working dead-end jobs and I was just tired of living paycheck to paycheck. And I asked him, what's a good trade to take up? And he said, there's not a lot of people doing heat and air. So I was like, okay.
This is one of those fields where the men, the vast majority that are doing it, are what we call aging out, getting 40, 50, and 60, and we're eyeballing retirement. And the problem is we're not getting enough young guys to replace the older guys. So guess what? Simple economics. Less guys in the field, that means the guys who are coming into the field are gonna make more money.
To succeed in this program, you gotta have the will to learn. It takes a lot just outside of the classroom to learn. It's not just taking the book, looking at the book. You got to practice. It's a skill which takes practice. If you like small class sizes, which a lot of institutions, like four-year schools, doesn't have the small class sizes, if you want a small class size learning experience, I think this program's great for you.
Mr. William R. Boyd started this program back in the early 70s in a burned-out warehouse off campus. When the Richard Building was built, the HVAC program, along with electrical, which was also off campus, moved in to the Richard Building and has been here ever since. And for me, everything that I know and everything that I've learned has been an extension of what Mr. Boyd taught.
Some of the instructors are alum of the program too, so they do take pride in passing on the legacy. I think it's a legacy of the program. So if you want to be a part of a program that enjoys and takes pride in what they do, the HVAC department is where you should be.